Steve, how are you doing? You okay?
Hi, Fraser. You okay, mate?
Yeah, very well. Thanks, very well.
Very good.
Busy old deadline day for you in the end then. You were pretty pleased with the way things went for you?
Well, pleased we didn't lose anybody. That's sometimes what I'm talking about after deadline day. Like anything, you know, you bring players in with the idea that it can help you. Proof will be in the pudding, whether that's the case. We'll certainly be working towards that. Very happy with the squad of players anyway. But they're always good to get some fresh faces in, and you know, hopefully, you know, it can help us going forward.
Of the three you brought in, Morgan Whittaker to start from Derby, what will he bring to the club, do you think?
Well, he's one for the future, really. How much of an impact he will have short term, you know, we're not too sure, but we're really happy that he's with us. You know, young player with potential, and you know, and looking forward to working with him and seeing him grow and develop in our first team environment.
Paul Ariola from obviously DC United. So there's a connection there with the club, two clubs obviously. But I understand he's got a real engine. This is a guy that runs all day and will not give up.
Well, you have to if you want to play for us. That's a non-negotiable, you know. And sometimes, you know, we've got a reputation for our style of play, and that's always the intention. But we want to play with a lot of energy and heart and soul as well. So that's what we require from every player. And yeah, any new player that walks through the door will quickly see that we're very demanding, and the players are very demanding of what we get out of training every day and what we expect in games, and quickly need to get on board. And that will be the case with all of the new lads that have come in.
And Kieran Freeman brings a fair bit of experience, particularly when it comes to getting promoted as well, which will be helpful.
Yeah. Obviously, the more players you can bring in with that sort of experience and know-how of the league, the better. Kieran certainly does that. Really, really happy that he's joined us, and it happened slightly later than maybe what we would have liked, but it's done now, and you know, we've got good strength and depth down that right hand side now with obviously Connor Roberts as well, who's been playing all of the league games particularly. So yeah, really happy with Kieran getting through the door.
And I understand you were interested in Sam Greenwood at Leeds, but that was a no-go, unfortunately.
I don't know. I mean, we were in for a number of players, or quite a number of players over the last few months. Some that you has kept, you know, lukewarm, and it might happen. Some that you have sort of turned down straight away. But there's a long list of players we inquired about.
Of the three that came in right at the end, are they all ready and able to play if needs be in this next game?
No, Paul Ariola won't be with us for a while. Obviously, coming from the US, it's a little bit harder logistically to get in. Not quite sure when he'll arrive, but the other two boys have been in training, and training ground's vibrant. Training's been excellent this week. And as it has been for a number of weeks, really, and we look forward to a good game on Friday night.
It'll be six new faces in all, I think, in January that have come in. How difficult is it to integrate new players into a squad when you want to try and get them playing at the same sort of level as everybody else?
Well, they haven't come in all at the same time, so it's been a bit of a drip fed, if you like, coming through the door. And like I said, the collective is the most important, and you know, we have a clear way of working and a clear way of playing. And anybody new that comes through the door has to get on board. So it isn't about the new players. It's working around them. It's about them realizing how we work and how we play. And as I said, quickly trying to understand. You know, we train them every day like we want to play. So you know, they quickly get the repetition and the ideas on and off the pitch with the analysis work that we do. As well, you know, bringing new players in transfer windows is normal, isn't it? You know, both in the summer and the winter windows, and allowing players time to adapt and seeing where they are in terms of being close to playing in the team is just part of the challenge of new players coming in. And you know, this window has been no different. Some of it forced on us a little bit because we unfortunately picked up some injuries of our permanent players, Liam Cullen and Wayne Routledge. We lost a few loans that we didn't really want to see the back of that got recalled. early on in January. So we had to bring in bodies, really. And now we've done that, it's all about putting it all together and hopefully serving us well going forward.
This game against Norwich, first versus second, it's a real mouth-watering tie, this one, isn't it?
It's got the makings of a good game. Obviously, they're going well, we're going well. They have a very clear way of playing. Manager, I have a lot of respect for the job that he's done. A club of great infrastructure and processes around the first team, which I think can be admired in the Championship, because you see now they've got promoted and, okay, they came back down, but they've been able to, or seems from the outside, there's been no panic or no drama, and they go in again. And I think that's a sign of a real stable club with great processes around how they work. So yeah, we need to be ready for the game, but it couldn't come any quicker. It's a game that we can't wait for. We back ourselves in every challenge that's in front of us, and this will be no different. The focus is on ourselves. We're at home. They're coming to us. You know, we need to bring our game to the pitch and be ready for it.
Norwich's last couple of games have ended goalless, and obviously you've got a fantastic defensive record. Do you take anything? Do you see anything in those performances? But I'm sure you've probably watched them against Millwall and Middlesbrough. Do you take anything from that?
Not really, because this season is unique in terms of the schedule and pitches and everything that's been thrown at every club this year. And I really think you've got to treat every game the same and, you know, respect the opponent 100%. What we're doing is focusing on ourselves and regardless of who we're playing, and we're expecting every team that we play against to be at their best, and we're ready for that, you know, both knowing what their team strengths are, but also the areas where we think we can go and win games from. Norwich are really, regardless of you know, what's happened in the last week or so, you know, whether they'd won games comfortably or lost games, you know, in the lead up to this, we would have been treating it exactly the same. You know, they're a good team, but we're going to be ready for it.
And obviously still a lot of points to be played for after this game. But if you were able to close the gap a little bit on them with a game in hand still, would that be a real boost for everybody at the club, do you think?
It's not something we're really thinking about, Fraser. As I said, you know, we this month is there's so many games to be played, and I just think you've got to take it day by day, game by game. Every game's worth 3 points, and that's the aim, you know. And you know, I guess there'll be a time in the future where we'll have to see where we're at, but I don't think that's now, you know, because there's just too many games right in front of us. So one game at a time, obviously. You know, Friday night football at the Liberty Stadium under lights. Pity there's no crowd, because it would have been rocking on Friday. But you know, a game that we want to really, really go into and be confident and take the game to Norwich.
And just finally from me, you mentioned just how tough it is in this league, and we've seen a casualty among the managers today with Jason Tindall losing his job at Bournemouth, and they're a club that are still in the playoffs. Is that just another sort of example of just how hard it is to be a manager in the Championship?
Yeah, it seems that, yeah, and you know, I'm fairly new to it, but I've done it now for 18 or so months, and it's demanding, it's hard, you know, and some things just don't go your way, and you can be unlucky, you know, and the other way as well. So you never want to see, you know, good coaches and good managers losing their jobs. And I guess, as you said, that's just another example of the industry that we're in. But, you know, Jason, I don't know Jason Tindall personally, but I do know about his history at Bournemouth and the role that he played. And I'm sure after the rest, he'll come back stronger.
Thanks very much. Best of luck, Steve. Thank you.
Thanks, Fraser. Cheers, see you, mate.
Bye. Hi, Steve. Simon here. How are you?
Hi, Si. You okay, mate?
Yeah, very well, thank you. Just on those transfers that you have completed, some fans have been critical in the past of how the club owners have gone about their business. I know the £11 million price tag of Joe Roden is probably the most noticeable criticism. But as a manager, how well supported have you been by the club's owners, given that you've made 6 signings this month?
I don't think about that too much. All I think about is the players that I work with every day. And, you know, one thing's for sure, when transfer windows finish, you know, you can't think too much about what you haven't got. You've got to think about what you have got. And that's always been my focus. And that's how it is. You know, I'm looking at the squad now, and I would have, whatever squad we had, and said, right, how do we prepare and win the next game? And that, you know, that's Norwich on Friday. That's all where my focus is in. We've got a few new players through the door that we're looking forward to working with. And we, you know, my work doesn't change.
Do you feel better placed now to gain promotion this season compared to, well, say last season? Obviously, it is an entirely different squad, but with these new individuals now, do you feel that your chances of going up are hopefully improved?
Well, we don't know. It's one we'll find out in the future. You know, we just have to, as I said, you know, we've brought some players in. You know, our work doesn't change. We're looking forward to a game on the weekend, and Friday night. And whatever squad of players that I'm working with, and I've said this after every transfer window, they get mine and the staff 100% service, if you like, and to help them, you know, play well and win games. So we're just looking forward to games now. I'm glad the transfer window's closed. You know, so no other teams can bring in players as well. We're not going to lose any players. You know, that's a big bonus, I guess, from this transfer window. And we look forward to you know, going through this mad month and seeing where it takes us.
Is there an exact time scale of when you can expect to see Areola come in? I know you said that there are a few stumbling blocks in terms of travel, but have you got an indication of when he'll join up with you?
No, I haven't, to be honest. And I think, you know, I've got a meeting later with the secretary, so hopefully we'll have some more information. But Morgan's through the door. He trained and Kieran the last 2 days. And obviously the boys are already with us. You know, have been a really good training week. You know, everybody's together, working hard, working smart, hopefully. And like I said, you know, we're just focused on the next game.
And that next game, of course, as you said, against Norwich, it really would be rocking if there was a crowd, but it still has that big match feel about it. Is that something you thrive as a manager off, these big, big games?
Well, I think we all have to. You know, I think we've got to embrace these challenges and look forward to them and have no fear, you know, and that's certainly been the talk this week. It's a talk going into every game, truth be told. It's about really backing ourselves, showing 100% belief in what we do and trying to do it to the best of our ability. And, you know, regardless of where and when you play Norwich this season, it's going to be a tough challenge. But, you know, a Friday night at Liberty, you know, it's got the makings of an attractive game, isn't it? And I really hope it is that. So we're preparing nicely for it, very clear about how we want to go about the game. You know, a little bit of final touches tomorrow on the training pitch and some video analysis, and we're back the lads to go and play well.
And just finally from me, you talked about the managerial merry-go-round, as it were. Norwich, in that sense, have sort of bucked a trend in that they've stuck with Daniel Farker, who obviously took them up, but then they went down from the Premier League. I guess it's nice to see a club stick by their man and have a bit of a long-term plan.
Well, I think it's because he's really good, you know, so I'm sure that, you know, the people that make them decisions at Norwich are aware of that. And they're clear, and you can see by the way they play, he's a really good coach and there's a clear way of working. But yeah, I mean, I think I've said before, you know, you can look at some of the work around Norwich from the outside and admire how they go about their recruitment, their succession planning, the way they play, as you said, backing the manager or the head coach, I think whatever it is, you know, the sporting director and all that sort of stuff. I think there's a lot to be admired about how Norwich, certainly from the outside looking in, it seems to be a very well-run, stable club that look after both the short and the long term. And because of that, you know, we've got a really tough game on Friday, but one we're looking forward to.
Good luck, Steve. Thanks a lot.
Thanks, Si.
Hey, Steve, you all right?
That's okay.
Yeah, maybe a little bit of a repeat of answers, but what I know you take one game at a time, but it's going to be an exciting week, isn't it, for everyone involved with Swansea City?
What, you mean playing Norwich?
Yeah, and then next week.
Oh, yeah. I'm not giving that much thought at the moment.
I know you don't.
We've got to look forward to these big games, Beth, you know, and good games. And I just love the camaraderie at the moment amongst the lads and the staff. And, you know, you're always aiming to work hard and to work smart. But if the boys could do it with a real positive attitude and a real smile on their face, then it just makes things easier, really, because everybody's mind is open to learning and to preparing for the next game while getting the best out of themselves. And I mean, I get that anyway off the lads. I've said numerous occasions they're a really professional bunch of players. But in the end, you know, it's an elite environment, and these big games are the ones that you want to be judged on. And Friday, as I said before, whenever we were going to play Norwich, home or away, whatever stage of the season, it's always going to be a really tough game. But we go into it with no fear, that's for sure.
Well, Norwich as well, you're close to the top. And I've been looking at the history sheet since 1920, played each other 57 times. You've won 23, they've won 24 and 10 draws. It's close wherever you look at it, isn't it?
Yeah. I wasn't born then, by the way, when I started. But and like I said, you know, it's going to be, you know, probably for the neutral, interesting one to call maybe on Friday as well. But as I keep saying, you know, we're really looking forward to it. You know, we're back ourselves 100% and hopefully we can play well.
Last one from me. I saw on Twitter the other week something really cool. It was a table of the first 45 and second 45 in a football match. And Swansea were, I think they were second and first. You know, other teams were like this. But it proves that consistently in your first half, second half, you've got, you know, you almost got the full 90 minutes sorted.
Easier said than done. I've said on numerous occasions, this league is a league that everyone strives for consistency, whether it be form, whether it be performances, whether it obviously results, whether it be in game, you know, everybody's striving for it. So the more aspects of consistency we can show, I think the better it will serve us longer term. So if there are some things like that look quite promising, then we've got to work really hard to keep that going. Because as I said, you know, it's such an up and down league where you get, you know, a completely different game from one game to the next. And especially this season where, you know, scheduling, pitches, I have to say pitches, you know, some pitches are probably not in the condition, which is nobody's fault. It's just the nature of going from one season to the next. I think that's going to play a part. Even more so in this season, if you can get consistency, then I really think it can help.
And I know, obviously, the, you know, the analysis and everything look at this, but for you, is there one part of the game which you still want to tweak to make sure it's that full 90? Because, you know, it will change, yeah. Won't it?
Yeah, again, it's like one of them things where from the last game you think, right, okay, let's start better or let's finish the game. And then it's normally the other way around, you know, how it starts. So I think we try and cover every aspect of the game as much as we can, knowing that it's, you know, it's never the perfect world, and it's, you know, a bit idealistic for me to think that way, but we always have a clear game plan, and you know, we always have a clear way of how we want to start and finish games. But unfortunately, there's ups and downs within both of them. You never know, you know, what's gonna, our game's gonna turn out. You look at our last game at Rotherham, you know, fairly comfortable, 2-0 up, all of a sudden concede off a long throw, and you have to compose yourself quickly and get back in the game. Whereas in so many occasions, there's games where it completely goes the other way, and rather than get another goal, and the game can quickly turn. So we're focusing as much as we can with our consistency, and in the end, as I said, if you can get a good level of consistency, then I think it's a really important aspect in this league.
Excuse me. I won't ask you to reveal any more secrets, especially ahead of the next week. Listen, good luck.
Thanks, Beth. Thanks.